हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीबडी, सत श्री अकाल, आदाब. सो आई वेलकम यू ऑल ऑन माय चैनल एंड आई एम वेरी मच एक्साइटेड एंड डिलाइटेड अबाउट मेकिंग माय यूट्यूब वीडियो एंड शेयरिंग माय एक्सपीरियंसेस ऑफ माय फर्स्ट इंटरनेशनल ट्रेवल. एंड आई रिक्वेस्ट यू ऑल टू सब्सक्राइब माय चैनल एंड डू क्लिक ऑन बेल आइकन सो दैट यू नो ऑल माय फ्यूचर वीडियोस कैन रीच टू यू एंड यू नो enhance your knowledge and understanding. So I my name is Dilbagh Singh. I carry a overall about experience of 2 decades. I worked about 12-13 years into telecom industry with big players like Bharti Airtel about 5 years, then in 5 years with Tata Teleservices, with Tata Docomo, and recently I was working about 4.5-5 years with Dish TV, Videocon, D2H, direct to home services. So this video is particularly about my visit to United Arab Emirates, and this video I'll be making it in English. This is the first video, so my future videos will follow with regional languages also. That is obviously the Punjabi and Hindi language I'll make. So to start with, for an international visit, if you want to go for out of India, you need to have a valid passport. By valid passport, I mean that it should have a validity of greater than 6 months left. Let's say if you made a passport 10 years back and now it is, about to expire in about 2-3 months, then there'll be challenges in getting visa. So the first and foremost thing you need to check it that you need to have a validity left for greater than 6 months, right? So other than that, there are visa requirements. So as per the recent announcements by Government of India and UAE government, specifically for the Indian passport, currently we have visa on arrival. That means you don't need to take a prior visa. You just, take your passport, take air ticket and go to UAE and they will give you a visa at the airport only. That will be around 14 days, right? So that is basically. And other than that, you have a transit visa since UAE and Dubai, and these are basically the majorly, trade business oriented countries. So there are a lot of, stuff coming from other countries and people used to purchase and then deliver to their own country or do import export kind of business. A lot of trading on that. So there is one transit visa also that is for 4 days, and one more use of the transit visa that if you want to take a connecting flight, let's say you gone to UAE, Dubai, and then you want to visit to London or to Europe, to Canada, then from there you will get a flight. So that will actually, break your journey into some parts and give you rest instead of a long stretched 12-13 hours journey, right? So now visa, as already told, that one is the transit visa, that's about four days, and the other one is that is visa on arrival that you get once there. So now that I talk about 1 month visit visa, which will cost you around close to 6,000, so as per the current rates. So and that is valid for 90 days. Now what I mean is that once you take the visa from the day it is valid for 90 days. So during these 90 days you can visit UAE for 30 days. That means you can go and stay there for 30 days only if you have a 30 days visa. So in this category there are multiple visas also. Multiple entry visas also and a single entry visa, so that there is a difference between the cost. So that cost you around 2,000 to 3,000 more, and the single entry visa at about 6,000, right? So similarly, if you need a 3 month visa, that will cost you around 15,000 to 16,000 Indian rupees for a single entry. In that you will have a validity of 90 days, and also you can stay there for 90 days in UAE, right? That is basically the visa process, and the charges for 3 months visa is about single entry is about 16,000, and multiple entry, that means you can go within 3 months, you can go multiple times to UAE, that will cost you around 21,000 to 22,000, right? So now how to get the visa, that is a very simple process. Either you can apply online. I'll publish some of the UAE government authorized links, the airlines like Air Arabia, yeah, right, Etihad. These airlines have been, you know, recommended by the UAE government. From there, they can issue you visa. So they'll take your basic documents. Like if you are working somewhere, then they'll require your income tax return for last 2 years. And I think salary slips, I haven't given salary slips. Usually if they ask, then you can provide for last 2-3 months. So in my case, I've given ITR for, I've took 1 month visa. So ITR for last 2 years, my passport. And once I got the visa, it takes one or two days, right? So once I got the visa, then these guys will ask to book a ticket. Right. You book a ticket, you need to book. Now here, one thing is that you either book a one-sided ticket or you can book a return ticket as well. So there is no, you know, specific requirement that you should, you know, book a ticket with return only, then only you'll get the visa. It's not like that. So you can book a ticket on one side. And then you can go there and then you can plan a travel back as per the date convenient to you, right? So this is the way you can get the visa, and then obviously you can do the online ticket booking and then you can enjoy your travel to the international tour. Thank you.